Hello, everybody, and welcome to Manor Lords. It is my absolute pleasure to share this with you, and I can't really express how excited I am to do so. Manor Lords is a game that's been on my wish list for a very long time, and I think it's been on a lot of other people's wish lists too. It's kind of a cross between a medieval city builder, and it's got a little bit of medieval Total War in there as well with the way the combat works. And I would like to take you through a pretty hard scenario that I've put together to kind of showcase some of the city building and also the combat as soon as possible. Let's just jump straight in, shall we? First things first, we need to set up our lord of the manor. I quite like this portrait. We will be the Froze family, I think, for this playthrough. Now, you can spend a lot of time customizing your own coat of arms. There's a lot of stuff in here to do. It's very, very detailed. But I have gone ahead and made my own custom coat of arms. You can see that I am quite the artist. A lot of work has gone into this one. Now, for our scenario that we're going to play, there are three templates we get at the start. There's the Rise to Prosperity template, which is just your vanilla, no enemies, just build your city, see your people grow, Anno style, I think, just build it up. There's Restoring the Peace, where there is an enemy faction off map and they have claimed some of the land and you need to take it back off them. Now, the problem with this is this does sound like the most compelling one to me. However, at the moment in this early access version, which is subject to finish, there's lots of stuff that still needs to be added to the game. They haven't finished implementing the AI actually being able to build its own city. So all it will do is it will send armies in from off map. As an alternative to that, there is also On the Edge. Grow your city and raise forces as quickly as you can. The lands are pestered by raiders and undefended settlements will quickly perish. Victory conditions, survive all the attacks and reach the large town settlement level. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to do the On the Edge. So our end goal is growth, which is reach large town settlement level to win. That doesn't mean we won't expand. No AI enemies because they're not available yet. No off-map adversary. We could actually add that as well, but I think we'll just leave that as absent. Raider frequency is on medium, so no more than a single raid every 2 years. We could bump that up to frequent, which means possibly less than a year between each raid. That might be quite hard to come back from. We'll leave that on medium for now. There's not going to be a raid for the first year, and there are no bandit camps available at the start of the game. The maximum amount that can spawn are 3. We start in spring, we have everything to do. I was toying with with putting a bandit camp on the map to start with, but honestly, I think we want a little bit of time just to build up our town and get ready for it. That first year will go by pretty quickly, and we'll be able to get into that very, very fast. Now that that's all done, our game is set up, let's jump in, and I'll take you through the basics of setting up your city in Manor Lords. So here is our starting settlement. Just a group of settlers and an ox in the middle of nowhere. The game's paused right now just so I can... Oh, the game's unpaused itself, which is interesting. I've just repaused it. You just sort of see how beautiful this game is. Now, I'm going to say the truth. My computer can't really push this game to its limits. There are other people probably uploading absolutely phenomenal footage. I'll focus on the gameplay, but I will pause from time to time just to look at how gorgeous this game is. If we zoom out, we can come all the way out quite far. And eventually we'll hit the map level. A little bit of LOD there. I don't actually think I can do that with the camera turned off. And now we're at the LOD level, you can see the entire region that we are in. And all of this area that you can see here, I can just zoom in onto, and that is more of the map. And this is all claimable by our manor lord as we gain the influence or king's favor. We can claim these other territory sectors and expand into them. But to start with, we're just here in Ekin now, which we will probably rename at some point. Our starting resources are pretty plentiful. We have a rich berry deposit, which we will make great use of feeding ourselves at the start of the game. We have a stone deposit, a clay deposit, a rich animal deposit, and an iron deposit. This makes us a very good starting territory sector for feeding our people, because we can actually get everyone fed pretty well without needing to worry about any crops or anything to start with. Now, our resources at the beginning of the game are limited, and we have a few pressing concerns on ourselves. The first is that our supplies and our food are lying out in the open. We need to get them undercover as soon as possible. Additionally, nobody has any homes right now, and over time, our approval rating is going to go down. So our primary goals right now are to get our supplies undercover and get our people into houses. But we also need to make sure that they are fed, and we need to make sure that their amenities are dealt with. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to build a logging camp. The logging camp will let us get food. I mean, I don't really need to go into that much detail for it. Let's build that back here. There's a pretty decent spot over here. As long as we're not interfering with the wild animals, we should be fine. I'm going to pop it just over here. I can hold down the mouse button to rotate it if I want to. And we'll just pop it down maybe about here. I will unpause the game as well now that I've actually placed something down. And what's going to happen is if we watch over here, the ox is going to come over to our wood stockpile, and it's actually going to drag the logs that are needed to build the lumberyard all the way over. And that's one of the biggest things that we're going to have as a bottleneck to our production at the start of the game, is that the ox is going to be having to drag things. So I will be speeding the time up a little bit once I've planned a few things out. Now, the next thing we need to do is I want to plan out a little bit of a road network. We've got a connection point for the lumber mill here, which I want to make use of. So I'm just going to bring that out to about here. You can curve our roads if we want to. I could just curve it like this. But just to keep it nice and simple, we're going to keep it straight. I'm not going to connect up to anything that we have over here at the moment. And we've got a new message coming in. This is just telling us that there are bandits coming. So if we track the movement, they're going to come in 1 year. Now, there's a road over here from the kingdom. We're going to connect up to this road. I'm going to make this curve a little bit just to keep it interesting. Don't want it to be too straight. There's no reason for it to do so. Well, maybe there is. I don't know. We'll just connect it on here. And we're actually going to do this also another kingdom road over here. So we're just going to connect back into this as well. And that is just our first two roads built. And that gives us something to anchor everything else off of. What I want to do is I want to build a small town with a market in the middle. And once we get to the market stage, you're going to see things are really, really interesting. The first thing we need, though, as I mentioned before, is we're going to need a granary to store our food, and we're going to need a storehouse to store our other supplies. If we don't build these before the first rain comes, we're going to lose all of the stuff that we've got stockpiled here. I'm going to build the storehouse probably about here on the main road, and then we're going to build the town kind of down here off the main road. So I'm going to put the storehouse here, and I'm also going to build a granary here. I'm just going to put them down now so that they are built. You can see they kind of snap to the road, and we've got a very big arrow to tell me which way they face. We have enough resources to build all of these at the start of the game. We also have a hitching post here. The hitching post is what the ox is assigned to. You can assign the ox to other buildings. For instance, I could, once it's finished, assign the ox permanently to the logging camp, which is needed because whenever your loggers cut down a tree, the ox is actually going to drag that back to the logging camp. And it's going to slow down production if you don't have one. Now the game is warning me that I have exposed goods, so we need to get on with building these. I'm going to pick the game speed up to 2. Just so that we're not waiting too long for things to be built. There is an option here. I can actually upgrade my homeless people's tents to a worker camp for 1 log. And that is something I've toyed with doing. It does stop your approval from going down, but it does mean that it gets a little bit harder to get people housed straight away. And I'm not going to do that for this playthrough, but I might do it if we lose this and go back in. That's our logging camp built. I'm just going to put this back onto normal speed for a second. If we come into the logging camp, you can see here that I have the option to assign people. Now, this isn't like other games where assigning someone assigns 1 worker to the building. If you look up here, we have 5 families who are unassigned and no families that are assigned. We have 10 people living in our village and they make up 5 families. We have 8 men and 2 women. Now, this game is kind of period appropriate, and it does kind of put a premise on the men in the families doing the physical work and the women doing more of the work around the house. So, for instance, if you're raising an army, that will be all of the men in your village will be the army and everyone else will stay behind. But for building something like a logging camp, you actually assign an entire family to the logging camp. So you'll see now that one of my families is assigned. And if I go into the logging camp and check people, this family has 2 men in it. They are both now assigned to the camp. And that's something you want to be very careful of. You want to make sure that these people maybe live close to the camp so they're not taking too long to walk to it. So rather than assigning a person, you assign a family, and that family idea is carried through the rest of the game. Let's just pick our speed back up again while we get the granary and the storehouse built, and we'll look at our next steps. So we're going to build a berry picking area to pick these berries, and we're going to build a hunting camp to start hunting down these wild animals. In terms of a village, I probably want to put my town square somewhere around here, and I want to build houses around it. I don't want it to be too square. One thing I am going to do is I'm going to move my hitching post. Now, I've had a couple of bugs with actually moving the hitching post. There is an option to relocate it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a new hitching post, and I'm going to put it down here, and eventually this will be upgraded into a stable. And then we'll delete this hitching post and we'll get the ox to clear everything up. You can see the ox is just picking up wood and delivering it to, there we go. Our storehouse and our granary are complete. I'm going to assign a family to the storehouse and I'm going to assign a family to the granary. That just means that we now have less people building buildings because the people that are unassigned are on construction duty, but then people are now going to start collecting the supplies that are lying out in the open and bring them back to this location. Now that that's done, I think it's time that we maybe looked at building out some houses for some people and getting some food under construction. It's a very delicate balance on whether you can get the houses built before people start to worry about food. We currently have 3 months of food, so we'd have a little bit of time to get this all built, as long as we don't take too long. I'm thinking that I want to maybe build a market square kind of, if we do something like this, I'm going to put our market square in here. Once these supplies are gone, I want our market square to kind of curl around here. We'll try not to stick to too many straight lines. We'll try and make this quite an organic looking town. And don't worry, if you're like, where's the combat? This is kind of just boring city building. The combat will come, and the combat is brutal. But just enjoy the ambience at the moment. Oh, I didn't show you this, by the way. We can also at any time pop into third person view and actually walk around our settlement. Now, at the moment, there's not much to look at, but you can see here we've got some people collecting the supplies and bringing them back over to the storehouse, which is pretty cool. He's got bread in his wagon. And what's this guy over here got? She is taking in, looks like some firewood. Ox is about to wipe us out with a log. It's still work in progress, but I really like this view. I think it's very, very cool. Our main objective, by the way, is to get 5 houses built. Once we've got 5 houses, we'll get a delivery of supplies, we'll get some spears and some shields, and we'll be able to raise a spear levy, which will help us defend. And then after that, our next objective will be to build a manor house for ourselves. And once we get that, we will get our own retinue of trained soldiers to help us. There's also mercenaries available if we need them. Right now, we're just waiting for this to be cleared up, and we're building up a little bit of a stockpile of timber. And we need that timber to build the houses for our people. Right, this is now gone. I'm going to just slow down time a little bit. We're going to disassemble this hitching post because I don't want it. I just closed it rather than disassembling. It's just not in a position I like. These tents will go away once people have houses built for them as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build something like this. We're going to maybe go out to here and in like this. And in this area here, we're going to have a market and a house. So I'm actually just going to build, we'll maybe just miss off the wall. We'll actually just put the house in there and I'll show you how the housing works. So we need to build a residential plot. We're going to select a burgage plot 1, not a burgerage, as I nearly said. And then we need to select which road it's going to face along. I'll say it's going to face along this road here. Then I set the edges of the plot. We'll say that it's going to go out. It's probably not going to be big enough if I do this. No, it's not. Let's bring it along a little bit. Maybe do something like this. It's still not big enough. Okay. Well, maybe just make this the market then. Let's build a couple of plots along this road here. So if I come along here to about this far out, come back to say about here, but I'll give it a bit of a slant, so I'll do that, and then come in here. Okay, that's 4 houses. That's a little bit too many for right now. Let's maybe come back to here into like this. There we go. We've got 3. I right-clicked while I was moving the camera. I want to try and keep our houses looking a bit quirky. I don't want them to be too uniform. I think that's a bit boring. That's a goal for 2 very big houses. So the blueprint that we're seeing here shows that there are 2 houses available here. There's room to expand the 2 houses to have a second family living in them. And they've got back gardens, which are quite large. Large back gardens are great for vegetable gardens. I'll show you that in a second. So I'm going to place these 2 plots down, and that's our first 2 burgages. So that's our first 2 houses for people to live in. Now, each of those costs 2 timber to build, and we currently have 2 timber. So I can build 1 more. I want to build maybe some smaller ones along this road here. So we're just going to place down a small plot and just see how cute we can make that. Maybe let's come back to here, and then we'll bring it in along this road. I don't actually want the expansion too much, but I want the plot. If we do this, I really want to experiment with some like strangely shaped plots. So let's see how that plot comes out as well. Maybe some really big gardens for our main villagers here. So they're now building 3 of these. We're going to get all 5 of them done. Let's speed time up again. And we'll just take a second to kind of watch the city kind of set itself up. I really like to just sit back and watch this game go. It is very, very relaxing. And once you get a bustling little town, it can be very beautiful. So you can see they've dropped off that that log. The ox is going back for another one. We've got a guy over here just clearing the land. Some nice little voice lines as well. Obviously, I'm not being able to put this at the highest graphics, but I think it's still pretty cool to see how good this looks as is. It looks like I accidentally slowed the time down again, so let's speed time up again. We'll just wait for the ox to come back. This is our main problem right now, is our ox, who's called Linhard, which I love, is the pressure point on building. He has to deliver these logs every time. Now what we can do is, if I wanted to, I could purchase another ox. We currently have 50 regional wealth. This is a resource we can use to purchase things, and I could use that to buy an ox or a horse. To be completely honest with you, I haven't found a use for the horse yet. I bought one in another game, didn't do anything. I used to buy another ox at the start, but I have something else I want to spend the regional wealth on rather than an ox, so we're going to leave that for right now. This house here is almost finished construction. Also, one thing I can do is I can unassign the people that are in the granary and the storehouse for now, because I don't actually need anything from these buildings now that the resources are protected. It's just very important to get them protected. While we're waiting, let's also site a well. This is an important building that obviously people need to drink. If we zoom out, you can see there are underwater rivers all over the, underwater water, underground water available. We just need to make sure our well is on that water. I'm just going to build it here just to make sure it's properly on the water, and that's going to be our town's well. Just a little bit down from the market. The lumber camp is a bit close, but it will eventually creep further out of the town. And I like to try and get the towns to develop a little bit organically as well. We'll see here in a second the burgage start to come together as they start to construct it. I do love watching people build buildings in games like this. I think it's very calming. It looks like the game slows down to normal speed whenever I go into the turning off the UI, so we'll leave that for the moment. In terms of what the other things at the top of the screen are showing, we've got 10 families. Our approval is going down because people are homeless. We have 100% public order, 50% regional wealth, 1 livestock, and 3 months before supplies run out. So you'll see here at speed, they are building the first of our little houses. And how much wood do we rectify 5 timber? So that's our first burgage complete. So there's a family going to move into here. Now, if I click on this, we actually have the ability to increase the level to which we can't do that. We can expand the living space to allow another family to move in here. And we can also construct a backyard extension. And there are quite a few of these available. These are the tier 1 ones. I'm going to slow the game down again for a second. And these are the tier 2 ones. Tier 1s are vegetable gardens, chicken coops, goat sheds, and apple orchards. But we need to unlock the apple orchard from the development tree, which we'll get into later. Vegetable gardens deliver you vegetables in autumn, so they take a long time to grow, but you can get a big yield of them. Chicken coops give you eggs all year round, and goat sheds give you hides all year round, which are all very, very useful. There's also the bakery, the tailor, the armorer, the blacksmith, the cobbler, the boyer, the brewer, and the joiner. These are all artisans. We'll look at them later. For now, I'm going to make this first house a vegetable garden. That's going to spend 15 of our regional wealth, and you can see that they now have vegetable plots in the back of the burgage. And that's one of the reasons I made this burgage big, was big lots of room means lots of room for vegetable plots, which means you can grow more vegetables. Now, this one over here has been completed, and it is a bit large, so let's actually save this for a second. I want to build another 2 burgages. I want to build one here. I want to make it quite tight. I think we'll be bringing it out to like this. I want to make sure it's got a backyard extension, though. That's very important. This one's got a backyard. I just need a cute little backyard expansion on this one. Let's do something like this. And I'm going to build another one next to it as well. And we'll just use the edge of the tents as a guideline for this one. And it's got a backyard extension as well. So these ones aren't going to be big enough to have an extension in terms of another family moving in. That's our well complete. Now we're going to build something else. We're going to build a marketplace. So we're going to set this area up in the middle of the town as a market. And I need to set another plot point. So what have I set so far? So here, I'll probably put the middle here. And there's 17 stall points for market stalls in our new market. Now, if I go back in here and I assign a family to both the storehouse and the granary, they will come and build market stalls, and that is where they're going to sell their goods. While that's happening, how are we doing for timber? We've got enough timber. I'm going to now build, under gathering, I'm going to build a forager hut. I'm going to build it back here near the berries. So just put it in the forest here. I don't want to uproot any trees, so put it here. And we'll just connect the road up to it. And that's going to be a job for one of our families. Now you can start to see where we've got some constraints. Because we have so many families working, there's actually only so many things they can do. And we're going to hit a situation where we're going to have more jobs that we need doing than we have families to complete them. Which means that growing your little town is actually essential to getting on top of things really, really quickly. Once we've got these 2 buildings built, we will get rid of the homeless tents. We're going to build some more houses along here for new residents to move in. I'm going to start working on trying to get some clay so that we can build a manor house. A manor house, when we go have a look at it, requires wood, planks, and stone. For some reason, I thought it meant it needed clay, but it needs stone. We have a stone deposit here, so we can get some stone from that. I also want to set some trade up so we can get trading in something simple that we're producing, and we'll basically take it from there. Let's speed up time a little bit. I'm very bad for putting it back to normal speed because I really like just to watch things go. I think this game is really, really good. I'm thinking about doing a separate video where I just set a town up, turn off the UI and just let it record for like an hour and put it up as like an ASMR thing, because I think it'll be quite fun to watch. So you can see we actually, this is really cool. We have two stalls here. We have a food stall. The food stalls will actually show you. So this food stall is selling bread. The food stalls will actually show you what they are selling. When we get a bigger variety of goods, you will see they will actually represent all the goods they are selling in the stall. This stall here is selling firewood. People need firewood and food to keep their houses, their families fed. Those are the two primary requirements at the start of the game, is food and firewood. Firewood is a bottleneck that you will probably run into quite quickly. We currently have 3 timber, and I want to build a hunter's camp, but that's going to unfortunately put us at the limit of what we can support. I'm going to build the hunter's camp back here near the clay, and we'll just add a road to that. What we're going to do is we're going to bring it down through these trees and then bring it into here. And once we've done that, we will have no families available to do any work anywhere else, but that's fine. We need to start gathering food. And then we'll look at firewood and we'll go from there. Here is the first rain of spring. If we hadn't gotten our goods under this into stores, they would have all been destroyed in this rainfall. So it's pretty good that we did that. Also, the music is just beautiful. This whole game, by the way, made by one person. I think 7 years work is what we're looking at here. I just cannot wait to get into combat for you. That's one of our Burbages done, and the second Burbage done. And now we have shields and spears in our inventory and a development point. The first thing we're going to do is I'm going to select this Burbage. I'm going to go into the Construct a Backyard extension button. And actually, I'm going to click on this message. Armament delivery. A strong militia is paramount to the survival of any settlement. Luckily, a shipment of weapons has just arrived, and you will now be able to create your first militia banners to serve you and protect your people. However, we need more weapons to equip all the people as the settlement grows, either by making them or importing them from other lands. So I can now form a militia, which I will look at in a second. But first of all, if I go into the development tab here, construct a backyard extension, I'm going to build a chicken coop for 25 regional resources. This family, in addition to their job, will also come and raise chickens. And they will produce eggs, which they will sell in the market, which will increase our people's happiness because they like it when they've got a variety of food to eat. At the moment, they only have access to bread, which is boring. But soon they will have bread and eggs. They can have fried egg sandwiches and they'll be very happy. Then later on in the year, they'll get carrots and potatoes and cabbages and they can have really nice sandwiches and they'll be even happier, but we'll be out of bread by then. I'm just going to make sure we get our forager hut built, and then we're going to get our hunter hut built. And then the other thing we want to do is actually want to build a couple more houses along here. So let's just lay down some more Burbages and get them building, because we want people to move in as soon as possible. So I'm going to maybe sort of set this up like this. I want it to be an interesting shape. Oops, no. I want this to go here. I don't have enough wood for that yet. So we need 6 timber to build what I want to build. So we'll just hold for that in the moment. And you can see now we've got our chicken coops built. And over time, you'll actually see some chickens. There they are. Just chickening about. Now, sadly, I don't think we can name or pat the chickens, which is a shame. But they are going to chicken about and they're going to produce eggs, which is going to make people very happy. I don't think I can select the chickens. No, I can't. Now, you can see here that we've got some amenity requirements for our people. They want access to water, which they've got. They also want access to a church, which they currently don't have. They want access to fuel. They want access to 2 types of food. And they want access to clothing. That's all things that we're going to try and focus on doing as soon as possible. But like I say, we are limited by our development points. Now, something else that happened is we actually got our first development point. So this is the development tree. There are 4 different sides to the tree. You've basically got what I would call agriculture, industry, kind of production. I can't make it trade, maybe industry, and living on off the land, let's say. If we look up here, we've got access to get orchardry. So we can actually get apple orchards in the back of our Burbages, and they can grow apples for us, which is just another food source. Sheep breeding, which means your sheep will actually multiply if you have sheep pastures. If you don't have this development point, your sheep will not have babies. The heavy plow, which allows you to plow your fields using an ox, which will make things a lot faster. We also have foreign supplies, which lets us build a firewood cart and a food cart, which is passively give bread and wood in your town without needing to import it. There's trade logistics, which just every time you create a trade wood, it's capped on how much it costs. A lot of these don't go anywhere yet, by the way. So this one here expands into better deals, which removes the tariff on foreign imports. There's also ones for here, so we get access to rye cultivation, irrigation, fertilization and bakeries. This game tracks the fertility of your fields and need to put them into fallow and stuff. And we've got basic armor making, which lets us access the armorer's workshop where we can make mail armor, plate, and helmets. Also got advanced armor making and master armor making. We've got charcoal burning, which means we can turn firewood into charcoal, which makes it twice as efficient. And deep mining, which means we can get infinite resources if we put them on a rich depot, which we don't have any. Trapping, which gives passive meat from hunters, which is what we're going to take. Forest management, so we make more berries from them. Beekeeping, which means you can have apiaries and people can actually grow bees. Well, farm bees. I'm so excited to get into that. There's advanced skinning and there's advanced beekeeping. For now, we're going to grab trapping. Trapping is just a really nice continual income of meat once you've got your hunting camp constructed. Let's speed time up again. We've got our chickens, we've got our vegetables coming in. Having a quick look at the army, we can create units for the army. There's four available to us right now. Let me just assign a family to the forager hut before I forget. Now we only have one family available for construction, so we need to keep that in mind. There's four units available at the moment. The militia footmen with axes, the militia footmen with spear, the polearm militia and archers. In terms of what we have available to us, we have 20 spears and 20 large shields, so we can currently make spear militia. There is also the ability to hire militia. There's for available right now the Brotherhood of the Forest for 60 treasury cost for each month. It's a unit of archers and brigands. We've got the Ravenous Vultures, who are all three units of light mercenary infantry, and the local thugs, who are just a bunch of people. We can actually afford to hire them if we needed to. There is a group I have seen called the Battle Brothers, which I loved to see when they showed up. At the moment, if I was to raise a unit of spear militia, we only actually have access to 10 soldiers, because we have 10 men in the family in the city right now. I want to bring that up to 20 before we raise the militia unit. We can raise it at any time. There's no rush. Now, I could assign somebody to the hunting camp, but I want to build some Burbages first. So I want to get these six, I want to get three more Burbages under construction before we start people hunting. So let's just try this again. We'll bring this to here, we'll bring it out to here, and then here. I want back gardens, so let's actually bring it to here and here. Still a bit awkward. Let's actually change this up. Let's go along. Let's start here and go like this. So that's the whole frontage of the plot. Along to here. I really want there to be back gardens. That's too many plots now. What if we instead just did along here to here to here? That's probably going to do. Just four small plots. And I can fit another plot in here when we need to. So we're going to get another set of houses built. That's going to help us increase the size of our town. What's going to happen now is we're not going to get any more disapproval from homelessness. And as we start to increase the variety of food that people can eat, we're going to get a thumbs up from that. We are also now a small town, so we can build a manor, but we need a sawmill and we need stone for that. I love hearing that the market stalls. The market gets bigger and bigger as well as your town gets more and more things in it. The other thing we could go for right now is if we feel like we've got the time, which I think we're actually doing very well, there's still 315 days before we get attacked, is that we could also, instead of building the manor house very, very quickly, we could build a church. So the church needs 20 planks and 5 wood, and it will actually allow for the requirement for faith to be built up in our town. And that is another way to go. But I think getting the manor up and running ASAP will help because we can start taking in taxes and we can levy our own special protection squad, basically. To get that, we're going to need to harvest the stone and we're going to need to build a lumber mill, sawmill. I'm going to just get the sawmill under construction because it doesn't hurt anything for it to exist. I'm going to build that down here quite close to the lumber yard, just so that it doesn't take too long for supplies to arrive. I want to keep this site open for residential, so we're going to put this here. Now, the game actually does have overlays for different things. So we've got an overlay for underground water. We've got an underlay for emmer fertility, so we can grow some... Oops, we can grow emmer down here, but that's about it. Let me just bring that back up again. So we can grow emmer down here. There's not really much else in this zone that's fertile. Flax fertility is even worse. Barley is equally quite bad. Rye is quite good. We can grow rye here and through where the forests are here. But interesting, there's also a smell, which is work in progress, and fire hazard, which is also work in progress. But they're just interesting that they are there. Something else that's really, really cool about the game is if I zoom out and come out to this view, you can actually see that our town is now a sketch on the map, which I just think is really just a really nice touch. And as the other players on the map, excuse me, would build their own towns, they would also start to appear on the map as well. At the moment, there is obviously nobody else on the map, but in later versions of the game, there will, of course, be AI players that you need to do diplomacy with and deal with. Now, the game is shouting us here because we only have 2 months of fuel available. So something else we need to think about building is a woodcutter's lodge, and the woodcutter's lodge will just produce firewood. Let's put that back here, just snugged into the trees a little bit. Oops. It's fine to just lay these things down, even if you don't have families to build them yet, so that they are constructed in time. Now, I should have actually just... Let me just change that slightly. I didn't realize it only had one access point. So I just want to rotate it until the arrow is pointing this way. And then we will get a road coming from here. We'll just bring it in like this. And what I'm actually going to do, I think, is I want to bring it along here. Just so we've got, we want to make sure that we don't end up with too many completely straight banks of houses like this. I think that's totally fine to front onto the market. But if you think about it in future, we want to make sure that people can get around our town and we don't want them to worry about the rows they take in and out. You can see our little farm here and now she has some crops growing in it, which is just so awesome. Just so much attention to detail in this game. It's like a lot of other medieval city builders I've built, but just taken to the next level. Let's just make sure time is speeding up. I want to just keep working our way towards getting that manor in place. That's a really big, big step towards preparing ourselves for bandit attacks. And what's going to happen is we're going to get bandit attacks, I believe, from off-map and bandit camps on the map that we're going to have to deal with. So there's going to be a few different challenges regarding the bandit camps. That's the sawmill saw pit constructed, although we can't do anything with it yet. There's a big pit in here. They put the log over these other logs here and saw it up. It's pretty cool. Perhaps he simply does not know it. Where did our... Oh, there's the firewood is here. So what we're going to do, once everything I've got under ordered for construction is constructed, which I think is everything has been, we're going to stop the cutting of logs. And we're going to switch to cutting firewood, and we're going to send the other group to the hunting camp. This is a slight annoying thing. The saw pit has enough storage for one log, and when that storage is full, we get a notification saying that storage is full. That's just a thing we're going to have to deal with. So let's get a family to the woodcutter's lodge, and let's tell this group to stop working in the logging camp and start working in the hunting camp. And what that's going to do is over time, and it has already started to happen, our market is going to start producing, having more types of food in it, and that's going to make people happy, and that's going to increase our approval rating. And as our approval rating goes up, we're going to get more people moving in. And just like I said, if we have a look here, we can now see more types of food available for sale in our market store. You can see the berries, and you can see the bread. I don't think the eggs show up, unfortunately, but when we start getting meat from the hunting camp, that will start to show up as well. So we're just going to fast forward now until families start moving in. There's not a lot else we can do right now. Everything has been built. The ox is just going to go around and pick wood up and move it. I don't think there's anything else that was waiting to be built, was there? No. There's a couple of trees that have had to be cut down over here, which is why he's moving wood. And we'll just wait it out. So we're in May now. Get a nice view maybe out from here. And I can even do like a slow tilt over the town. As you can see, the people moving in the distance. We've already got a cute little town, I think. The market will look good when it grows. We could maybe try and site the church here or put the church here. Or we could put the church back here and have a road run around the back. In fact, I think I might just place that road now, just so I've got something to do. So we'll just bring a road around the back of these houses. These Burbages. Actually, the size of this plot makes that a little bit difficult, but we'll just bring it around like this. Maybe just bring it in tight. And we just got a way so I don't need to worry about knocking people off. And let's actually do the same thing here as well. We'll make this a little bit of a crossroads. And we'll just bring a road. Why is it coming out like that? Doesn't want to go that way, does it? It's now summer. Nobody has moved in yet. We'll leave this road for the moment. It's being a little bit funny. Oh, we've had a new family move in. That's excellent. Okay, this is now a really important moment because we can start getting some resources together. So I'm going to... How many timber do we have? Let's set a construction reserve of 3 timber. And we're going to start getting this new family to produce planks. And those planks are going to go towards our manor house so we can get that built. So summer, if you've got crops, they'll grow and you'll get some droughts. And then in autumn, you'll harvest and plant and sow new crops. And then in winter, you have to survive without getting any crops. And so surviving your first winter is actually a big early challenge to the game. We now have 19 months worth of fuel and food and 4 months worth of fuel. So we're doing pretty well on the food and fuel game. How are we doing for food in the marketplace now? So there's meat here now as well. So you can see here now that there is meat hanging. It's something when I get another couple of families in is we'll build a tannery and they'll start to produce clothing for people as well. And that'll make people very, very happy there too. We now have 270 days before our first raider attack. So we do need to get ready for that. What else can we do right now? I think we're just basically waiting for people to move in. We've got, if we go here, we've got low population growth because our approval is still seen as neutral. Unfortunately, every time a family moves in, you seem to take a slight homelessness tick for a second, and that drags your approval rating down until 30 days past that it goes back up again. So we are combating that a little bit. We just want to keep building the size of the town. We do not have anyone free. How are we doing for planks? We've got 5 planks. I think we need... How many do we need for the manor? We need 20? We need 20 planks. So each timber is 5 planks. So we basically just need to cut 4 planks up to get that amount. And then we need 10 stone, was it? Or 15 stone? We need 15 stone. We currently have 10 stone. We're also going to need some lumber. So we'll just keep coming toward... Get that moving forward. I'm just going to fast forward again until another family move in. We have room for 8 families at the moment and 6 are living with us. And that's us up to 5 planks still. Takes a little bit of time to make planks in the sawmill. You can see our approval just took a jump there. And we're up to 4 months of fuel. Food is great. We're doing great on food, which is fantastic. That's another plank. This warning here lets me know there's another plank about to get cut up. There is no food will not deteriorate until you fill your stockpile up. So as long as the granary has room in it, you don't need to worry about food expiring. Food's invulnerable, basically, as long as it's in a granary. Still waiting on that other family to move in. Everyone else is just doing their thing. We've got the woodcutters cutting wood over here. Our hunters are creeping off into the forest from the hunting camp. A lot of these buildings have upgrades available for them as well. For instance, if we have a look at the forager hut here, we can actually build a herb garden for it eventually to give them some more variety of what they're bringing in. And as time goes by, people will want a greater and greater variety of things that they're eating and that they are wearing, etc. So we currently have 4 different types of food in here. The eggs are really helping pushing our approval rating up. And that's going to make life so much easier in the long run. Up to 15 planks now. I think I set it to 3, so let's just set this to 2, just so they build that last plank. We've got a new family moving in. That's excellent. I want them to build for me a stone cutter camp near the stone here, and we'll just attach that to the road as well. And once that's built, we'll get them to harvest the stone, so we've got the stone to build the manor house too. So that's me up to 20 planks. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to remove the family from the saw pit and I'm going to get them to come over to the logging camp and we'll start cutting down some more wood. And we probably want to look at pushing this logging camp further back into the woods at some point. There is a forester available, but I think pushing them out makes sense anyway to build the size of the town. Now, we currently have room for 1 more villager, so I'm not going to build any more Burbages until that's full. And the stonecutter camp is under construction. There won't be that much stone here, but I don't need to harvest that much either. Just taking a moment, you can see all the trees leaning in the wind. When you get some summer storms, there's some fantastic lightning. I really hope that I'm doing justice to just how beautiful this game is. It is so good. It's also just, it's tickling an itch for me for city building in a way that City Skylines really didn't. And I was really disappointed with City Skylines, but this is... I think you can tell I'm really enjoying Manor Lords. There's a lot still to be added to the game in terms of, you know, features that we want to see, like, you know, the development tree still has a lot of stuff hidden in it. Also, we didn't even have a look at policies or production yet. These aren't fully implemented yet. I didn't even actually know how to get... Oh, these come from the Manor House, of course. We'll look at those when we get the Manor House built. That's our main objective right now, is to get ourselves a Manor House. Once we've got the Manor House, we can also look at planning a castle. There's so much to do. But let's pick the speed back up again. This is quite far away, so it's going to take a little bit of time to get built. How are we doing for resources? Okay, Stonecutter Camp has been constructed. So that just lets us assign a family here, and they will start to produce stone for us. And then basically, as soon as we hit 15 stone, and I think it's, is it 6 timber? 5 timber. So we just need 5 stone and 1 more timber. We've got enough to build the manor house. After building your first manor, the starting retinue will join you in your palace for free. And getting that retinue is going to be extremely important for fighting the bandits once we start raising our levy. If we check now as well, by the way, we can now raise 14 recruits. So we're almost at our max size to be able to bring together a full militia. We don't actually want to do that all the time. The militia are made up from the men in your village, which means if they are in the militia, they're not out cutting down trees and harvesting. But the women will continue to work in all the jobs, but they won't join the army. So you really don't want to be doing that until you're ready to do it. You don't want to be raising armies before you're actually fighting. That's just a waste of manpower. Oh, someone just cut down a tree over there. That was pretty cool to see. Oh, we got a lightning storm. Let's see if we can catch any lightning. It is daytime, so it will be hard to catch. There was some lightning, I think, over here. My graphics might not be good enough to... Oh, there we go. Yeah. Look, trust me. I've seen what it looks like in the really good rigs. It looks so much better than that. There's definitely a few things my game is struggling with, which is a shame. I have a computer upgrade planned, but whether I can afford it is another question. I would love to get a new graphics card and update my processor and stuff to really give this game justice as it gets closer to release. Because I really want to show it off for everybody. And I've got... You know, it's a very... lucky thing that I've gotten this early access to it alongside a bunch of other really great content creators, and I want to do it justice, you know? Games like this are pretty rare. Labors of Love definitely tend to have something very special about them. Dwarf Fortress and this, and yeah. We should start thinking about where we want to expand into next. Somewhere that probably has a good source of clay would be good. There's a rich clay deposit here, or a rich deposit of stone, or a rich deposit of iron. There's a rich deposit of iron up here in Goldhof, so that might be an end goal. We might come through Weru, or we might come through Wildbrand to find it. So that's something to think about. How are we doing for supplies here? Okay, we have the stone. I no longer need a family working at the Stonecutter camp. I only needed that stone to get the manor house built. We're just waiting for one more timber, and then we can get the manor house under construction. And I'm really excited to get the manor house built. Where are we going to site the manor house? That's the question. Do we want it on the edge of the market over here? Do we want to snug it in here if we can? Put it in this crook here, or put it behind the houses, maybe a little bit away from everybody else, nestled into the trees where we have a little bit of land to ourselves. I think that, for me, is the place to put it. Okay, here comes a log to come into our supplies, which is great. One of the things we'll buy once we get a little bit more regional wealth is another ox. And we'll probably end up assigning an ox permanently to the logging camp, and maybe another one. You can assign an ox to the log to the saw pit as well. It just means it makes hauling that wood around a lot easier. That's us. Oh, still at 5 timber. Okay, I thought that was going to be a 6th timber arriving, but we are still at 5. So we're just waiting for that 6th timber to come through. Let's speed time up again. Even in the rain, it's still a beautiful game. And the ambient sound, especially when you come in low and you're looking, you know, through the town, the puddles, it really does feel like I've walked into a town in The Witcher sometimes. We need to get a tavern down as soon as possible as well, but we need to be able to brew beer for that or buy beer. So that's not going to happen straight away. Currently still at 5 timber. Let's just fast forward until we're at 6. As again, there's just waiting up. There's the 6 timber. Okay. Let's get our manor house under construction. It's not too big right now. I think I am going to do what I said. I'm going to build it back here. Just a little bit in the trees. Just so we're a little bit, you know, we're not right on top of the peasants. We don't want to be right on top of them. Now, this is our castle planner. And this is where we get to design the castle that we're going to build. And now, the bigger we make this, the more it's going to cost. And right now, we don't really have a lot of resources. We can come back into the castle planner later to build up our castle. We can build walls and gates. Gates are created automatically when a wall is placed over a road. Every gate adds 1 timber to the construction cost. We can add outer towers. Provides 10 garrison space. Garrisoned units and villagers shoot projectiles at approaching enemies. Garrison tower increases maximum retinue size to 12, limited to just 1 per region. And tax office, cosmetic only under rework. So we will want to build this at some point. But for now, there's nothing. I'm not going to do this. So we'll just click commit I'm just going to build the basic manor house to start with. What I will do is I will add a road that comes down to here. And we'll get the manor built. Now let's go, just fast forward to the construction of the manor house. It's going to take a little bit of time. There's a lot of supplies to bring over to it. We will see everyone start bustling over with the supplies. We've got the ox. We're actually going to go for a super fast forward for this. Oh, so all these houses have back gates to them. So everyone's going to just come out the back to build our manor house. As I said, there's not a lot they can do until the ox brings all of the wood. So we just need to wait for all that to come through. And that's also going to start rebuilding our other stocks. We've got a new month. So we actually have new mercenary companies. We'll have a quick look at those. We've got the Wayward Sons, the Brother of the Forest, and the Battle Brothers. Stories tell they all lost a bet with their former legion, a brothel, leading them to abandoning their former lives to join them as fighters. They decided to stick to this life. That's awesome. We'll have to hire the Battle Brothers at some point. We have a new family moving in as well, so our Burbages are now all full. Let's get another Burbage under construction, just so that I don't forget about it next time. But we're not going to build it this time. Now, I could squeeze it in here. I did say that I wanted to put a road here, but I think I'm actually going to squeeze a little Burbage into this slot here. I think that's going to be quite a cute place to put it. Just a small one. But we'll set its construction priority to low, just so that it's building in the background. It does also mean that we now have two families able to do work on the construction of the manor house, which is, of course, the most important building in this settlement. And what we'll do, I think, is we'll save the construction of the manor house for our next video. And we'll leave this one here for now. Now, I'm not planning on making you wait a lot of time for the next video. It should be out tomorrow. But just, what do you think of Manor Lords so far? I know we haven't had any combat, but I don't know about you. I think this is a gem. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I certainly enjoyed making it. I'd just like to give a special thanks to Hooded Horse for giving me early access to the game. And everyone who supports my channel either through Ko-Fi or Super Chats or through subscriptions or through channel memberships or just hanging out on the Discord. Thank you all so much. I appreciate all of you immensely. I can't tell you how much you brighten up my day every day. If you like the game and you're interested, please leave a comment or subscribe to the video. Let me know what you think. I'm really interested to see what people's impressions of this are, since I know there's a lot of hype around the game and I hope it lives up to the hype that you had. If you thought this video was a little bit slow and boring, let me know as well. I could do a more combat focused one next time instead. For now, I'm going to leave you with H and How, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao for now.